So I think, Hunter, I want to bring you in on this because the rumors abound, and there's very few sort of legitimate court documents that will attest to what has happened to all this money. But listen, it was attested too that back in the divorce in 1999, she got $2.5 billion. Obviously, Alec was loaded, and $100 million per year for 13 years. There's been some talk about that being crunched down to $100,000 per month. Could you imagine living on that? Wouldn't that be tough?
It's going to be very tough for anyone to live on $100,000 a month here in New York.
In New York, right.
Most of us have that, I think.
No. But you remember this. I mean, you remember this woman plaguing the headlines, and here she is 20 years later sort of jumping right back in with the violence and the real estate issues.
Anyone who lived in New York in 1999 and around that time frame lived their divorce on a daily basis. The pictures in the front page of the press every day, the fight between them, the allegations of catching the husband in bed with another woman.
The Russian model.
I wanted to be delicate about it.
Not just another woman. Come on.
and then pulling a gun on the wife who walked into the house, and then the fight over the family mansion that she wouldn't leave.
Right. And I think if those headlines weren't big enough, the fact that she went to all these society events to be photographed with, you know, a face that she admitted she wanted to alter so she could look like a cat. And this is how the surgeries have turned out. There have been multiple surgeries. She's admitted to this. She said she wanted to be a cat. She has posed like a cat. There's a slight progression here, but it's even more severe than that when you look at the totality of her surgeries over the years. She's this fixture in New York City, and no wonder she has that nickname, Catwoman. We'll leave it there. Wish the best for Ms. Wildenstein in her real estate and her, her assault woes. I hope you are not making big plans.